In this video I will show how to convert a 3D printer into a plotter with automatic pen changer. The printer I am using is from the Zonestar P802 series that I have reviewed in detail in previous videos. For my first tests I have created a simple pen mount using the Zonestar in printer mode. The material I am using is PLA. The layer height is set to 0.2mm and the print was finished after approximately 4 hours. 4 additional 3mm screws as well as the 2 screws from the front fan are needed besides the printed part. With the 3mm screws at the rings you can adapt the holder to various pen diameters. The pen must be able to move in vertical direction to draw reliably even on not so flat surfaces. With hot glue I fixed a 10mm nut on the pen, for 2 reasons. The nut works as a stopper, preventing the pen from falling down, and the additional white keeps the pen on the surface while drawing lines. The pen holder replaces the fan on the front side of the printhead. I'm using a plug with protection against reverse polarity so that I can remove the fan quickly. As you can see, the tip of the pen is clearly lower than the tip of the printer nozzle. That's why the end switch of the Z-axis has to be triggered sooner than in printer mode. I have printed a couple of spacers to be able to adjust the new home position of the Z-axis. Attach the spacer that fits best for your pen on the screw that triggers the end switch. Make sure that the tip of the pen hits the surface between 2 or 3mm before the switch is triggered, so that plotting even on a rough surface works fine. With that, the conversion is done and so the printer prepared to work as a plotter for the first time. As usually you can select a file in G-code format on the SD card through the printer menu and start the print job that now is a plot job. In contrast to 3D printing, only few parameters have to be adjusted for plotting. First, there is the vertical movement of the pen. In high position, no lines should be drawn, while in low position, the tip of the pen must touch the surface reliably during movement. Secondly, you must set the maximum speed while drawing on the surface. And finally, the maximum speed when moving to the next line with the pen lifted above the surface. For my first test I've set the drawing speed to 30mm per second, the movement between lines to 100mm per second, and the lift of the pen to 10mm. The default maximum speed of set movement is set to no more than 2mm per second in the Repetier firmware. To speed up my plots I have adjusted that value to 100mm per second through the printer menu. With those adjustments, the plot was finished after approximately 2 minutes. To get good results, adjust the holder with the 4 screws to lowest backlash possible so that the tip of the pen doesn't move too much. I'm using a Perl script to generate G-code files from Scalable Vector Graphics, a file format that common vector graphics software can import or export. My choice is LibreOffice Draw. Before exporting you must convert all paths into polygons. Details about using my script are available on my pages. You can access the printer through USB as well. Here I'm sending G-code lines directly to the printer using a tiny command line program. With that you can transmit coordinates to the plotter, which is a nice demonstration of the working principle of CNC machines and a practical application for maths. It's a quick task to calculate and transmit coordinates for a triangle. from a triangle. Through a square. And an octagon, the shape of the drawing goes step by step to a circle. It's a lot more convenient to let some lines of software code do the calculations and store them in a file or transmit them directly to the plotter. Typing the coordinates of an approximation of a circle having 100 lines manually would be extremely time consuming. With the tiny command line program you can also send G-code files to the printer through USB, so that there is no need for the SD card. The extremely simple hardware conversion of the printer results in a great tool to learn and teach coding of CNC machines or geometry in general. The axes of the Zone Star are orthogonally, so that the points in space correspond to Cartesian coordinates, but what the maths behind the movement of the machine is straightforward. Once more I was using the Zone Star in printer mode to create a couple of more parts. In prototyping there is, the first print is usually not the final design, the parts shown here were simply a bit too wide. My second approach works fine. The new holder is designed to automatically pick up pencils. In my first version I was using aluminum square tubes with an edge length of 20mm, something I have always laying around in my workshop. As seen later, printed square tubes work as well with only a minor loss of precision. As an advantage you can easily adapt them to the dimensions of nearly any pen. I had to trim the markers I'm using to no more than 12cm to make them fit under the inactive pens that are parked at top of the plotter. The square tubes are guided by the new holder that can be adjusted through 4 screws to minimize backlash. Instead of the 10mm nut I'm now using a printed part to prevent the square tubes from falling down. The subframe for the inactive pencils is mounted on top of the printer. To do so I had to replace 4 screws by longer ones screwed in the other way around. Up to 4 markers can be parked in the subframe, enabling you to create colored plots. To change color, the current marker is placed in the subframe. While the new marker is picked up afterwards. While going up, the plotter is moving the x-axis left and right, so that the square tube slides in easily. My Perl script for vector graphics conversion inserts the commands needed to change color automatically. You just have to determine the positions of all pencils by driving the axis manually and type the coordinates in the source code of the script. The lengths of the pen sticking out of the square tubes should be as short as possible to get highest precision in plotting. Filled areas are plotted with hachures. Calculating the lines for an infill is tricky, at this example I've created all paths manually. My Perl script ignores filled areas, only lines and outlines are transformed into G-code commands. Even with the cheapest inkjet printer you get better graphics on a piece of paper, this plotter is more an educational tool than a machine that plots your photos. The glass tile is clamped on the print bed with a lap of approximately 4cm at the front edge to compensate for the offset between printer nozzle and pen. You can plot interesting figures based on functions by typing only a few code lines. The first example draws ellipses. The second example draws spirals. And the third example draws parabolas, including the coordinate axis. An advantage of this plotter over an inkjet printer is that you can draw on the surface of nearly any object having a flat surface that fits on the print bed. Here I'm plotting on a mirror tile using permanent markers. When using non-permanent markers, you can test your software quickly without wasting lots of paper sheets whenever an experiment fails. You can get all 3D files used for this printer conversion as well as the software I'm using on my pages. How to go beyond printing and plotting with this SoundStar is shown in other videos as well as on my pages. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.